Beresheet, in the beginning. Johanan, John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim, and the Word was Elohim. Isaiah 46:10, declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times the things that are not done yet, saying, My counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure. So what did he declare from the beginning? I think if you look into Beresheet, you can see some of the things Father has declared from the beginning. So let's start with looking at the letters that make up the word Beresheet, that means in the beginning. The first letter we come to is the Bet. The letter Bet means within or in. It refers to a place of dwelling like a tent or a house, for the house of Yah is within. Psalm 119:11. I have treasured your promise in my heart, so that I may not sin against you. Notice how the word in is used in the scripture. The next letter we're going to come to is the letter Resh. It means poor in spirit or bent over and humble before Yahuwah. The ancient form was in the shape of a man's head. It means the thoughts of man or the intellect is wicked and in need of a father for salvation. Jeremiah 17:9, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked, who can know it? Psalm 119:153, see my affliction and deliver me, for I have not forgotten your Torah. The next letter is Aleph. Aleph means strength and leader, though it's in the form of an ox and has to do with being yoked. This symbol represents the Father, Yahuwah. It even has the same gematria as the Father's name, which is 26. There are two yods and a vav in the modern Aleph symbol, totaling 26. And the Father's name, or Yod He Wah He, has one yod, which is 10, two hays, which is 10 total, and a wah, which is a total of 26. Psalm 119:3, they do no wrong but follow his ways. If you are following him, then he is your leader. The next letter we come to is the letter Shin. Shin has seven parts, four yods and three vavs, to make up the letter, which means teeth in the ancient, and it is in the shape of a flame, which shows it represents the divine, with seven parts like the seven churches, the seven spirits before the throne. It can mean destroy, as in the seven plagues, seven seals, seven trumpets, and seven vows. It is also the symbol of a crown, like a crown of flames. Psalm 119:164. Seven times a day I praise you for your righteous laws. Next letter we're going to come to is Yod. Yod means the hand of Elohim, or the spark of creation, for by his hands all things are created, and it does mean also work. Psalm 119:73, your hands have made me and formed me, given me understanding to learn your commands. The next letter in Beresheet is the Tav or Tau. It means a sign or a mark or a covenant, and it was in the ancient as a cross. Psalm 119:170, may my supplication come before you, deliver me according to your promise. The words that are found inside of Beresheet. The first word in Beresheet you see is Bar, which means sun, or Bet Resh. The second word you see is Bara, which means created. The third word you see is Ra, which means to see, behold, or foresee, or perceive. The third word you'll find is Rosh, which means chief or prince. It refers to the head, and it can also mean the crown as well. The next word in Beresheet is Esh, which means a fire or burnt, like a burnt offering given as a sweet smelling aroma. The next word in Beresheet is ashit, which means to appoint or impose, to put or to place or set. The next word in Beresheet is shay, which means a gift offered as homage. See the definition below. Notice the next letter tav, which means the cross. The next word in Beresheet is shayith, which means a thorn or a thorn bush, like a crown of thorns. Now that we can see some of the words that are within Beresheet, let's see what kind of sentences or messages inside of Beresheet. The house of Elohim, bit. The man comes from heaven, resh. The Father will crown him for his work, yod. On the cross, tav. Next we see the son, bar, of Yahuwah, aleph. The prince, Rosh, from his habitation, which is heaven. Through his divine work, Shin, Yod, he will create a covenant, Tav, on the cross. Biet, heaven is his home. Bar, the Son, came from heaven. The Bar, son of Yahuwah. Behold, the prince from heaven, the burning bush of thorns, gives a gift of homage, a renewed covenant, placed on his head a crown of thorns. The wickedness of man, Yah destroyed by his hand on the cross. The burnt offering is a gift of salvation, for Yah has become Yahshua. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Sometimes in scripture you can find meaning in things when they are written backwards. If you look at Genesis 6:8, but Noah found grace in the eyes of Yahuwah. If you look at the way Noah's name is spelled, Nun Chet, if you spell his name backwards, it's Chet Nun, which means grace. So Noah is a mirror of grace. Let's look at some words that we find in Beresheet when we go backwards. We go backwards, we see the word goat, tayish. If you look at Leviticus 16:22, Aaron shall lay both his hands on the head of a live goat and confess it over all the iniquities of the peoples of Israel and all their transgressions, all their sins, putting them on the head of the goat and sending it away in the wilderness by means of someone designated for the task. The goat shall bear on itself all the iniquities to a barren region, and the goat shall be set free of the wilderness. Yeshua is our scapegoat. He bore all of our sins onto himself, and he set us free. The next word we come to is tashah, which means to bear or to carry, to endure, to suffer, to forgive, or marry. The next word is issah, which you see in Deuteronomy 33:3. Yes, he loves the people. All the holy ones are in your hand, and they sit down at your feet. Everyone receives your words. The next word is rab. Rab means much, many, and great. It means abundance. So going backwards in Beresheet, we see on the cross, he became the scapegoat. He suffered and endured and carried the cross so that everyone receives an abundance in heaven. 2 Corinthians 5:21. For he made him who knew no sin, to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of Elohim. This is from the Hallelujah Scriptures. Thank you guys for joining us today for the study of Beresheet in the book of Genesis. We will be doing another video on the parallel of Enoch 69 in Genesis 1, and hope you will come back to join us for that study as well. So until next time, Shalom.